14. Let's skip all the way down to verse number 41. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, they all recite the same story. They all talk about this garden experiment, this garden of Gethsemane. Some elements, some put in, the others were put in, and vice versa. But they're all important. It came a third time. Is that what it says in your Bible?
Yes.
And said unto them, sleep on now.
Yes.
And so you'd have slept through all the important stuff. You might as well keep on sleeping.
Yeah.
Amen. Because now you don't need to sleep. Huh. I was at the hospital with the family, and I said, you know what? Y'all been in this hospital for 2 days. You ain't brush your teeth. You ain't comb your hair. Go home. Brush your teeth. Take a long bath and comb your hair. He's here. You're going to need your strength once this is gone.
Yeah.
Because let me tell you something. If you don't get any rest and now he's gone, now the phones are ringing off the hook.
Right.
And you got all these people with these why questions. And you don't have the strength, the power, amen, and the rest to think about it. And next thing you know, you're crying with them.
Wow.
Then why God had to take my dad? Why God had to take my son? Why? Because you are not rested. And you're not ready. I told him, go home and rest. Get refreshed. Amen. You're no good for somebody when you have no faith.
That's right.
Pastor Nolan, do you think he can hear us? Of course he can hear you. He can hear every word you're saying. Hold his hand by faith. Let your father know you're here. Amen. All this negative stuff you're doing in the room, don't you know he can hear you? You don't have anything good to say, go out in the waiting room. Go out in the hallway.
Wow.
But there comes a time you just got to say
enough.
That was a hard funeral, by the way. I was telling my wife I did not want to do a funeral.
Wow.
Because then you have these people who don't listen to God, but they want God to show up. I said, look, God's not going to show up when you're all unorganized. You're not doing anything according to the word of God. You're just trying to please the flesh and give entertainment. This is not an entertainment service.
Wow.
This guy was only 55 years old. This is a funeral. It's not a celebration. I don't know, we'll have a good time. We will have a good time and the Holy Ghost will show up. But you can't dictate to him, we're gonna have a good time because you decide to have a praise dancer or your favorite singer. One of the pastors came to me at the end of the service. And Pastor Nolan, has funerals changed since I did a funeral last? Because I don't recognize anything y'all did today. I said, I did what the family asked. Amen. Oh yeah, I preached at the end, but all the way up to then, everything they asked to do was done.
Yeah.
Just like they wanted. It was their service to their loved one. Was it right? No. And I told him, don't you ever do a funeral like that if you can avoid it.
Right.
Amen. But when you do it, and this is for some of y'all that have to do funerals, why you come in? For these days, some of y'all gonna be preachers, ministers, whatever. Somebody gonna call you for some information because most people don't go to church anymore.
Right.
So when it comes to do a service, they don't know what to do.
Right.
Amen. I'm supposed to do the eulogy. They put me down to do a song. I said, yeah, I will sing, but I'm going to preach first. It came a third time and said to them, sleep on now. Take your rest. It's enough.
Yes.
In other words, Jesus said, I'm done.
Yes.
I'm done asking you to pray for yourself.
Yeah.
Enough. There's going to come a time when God's going to look at us and say, you know what? I'm done with this church in America. I'm done with the church around the world. Let's just get the remnant out. Enough. Let's go on. Let's move on. Amen. Move on. I said my wife would text her, baby, move on.
All right.
Move on. That's Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Now what was going on is now here comes Judas walking up with his bride. And do you know what Peter did when Judas came walking up with the crowd? He pulled out his sword. And he cut off the high priest's son's ear, or whatever, right? Why he pulled out the sword and cut off the ear? Because he did not pray to not enter temptation because he was sleeping. So that when the devil came, he responded the wrong way.
Amen.
That's why Jesus said, put away the sword.
Yeah.
He reached down and grabbed the man's ear and stuck it back on. Don't cut the ear off. He's going to need that to hear. How can he hear without an ear? He needs to hear the gospel to be saved.
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? You're going to always respond wrong when you're not prayed up. When you're not prayed up, when the devil comes in, when the enemy comes in like a flood, you don't realize in the word, my God shall lift up a standard, and you lift yourself up. And then you get your block knocked off.
Amen.
Because now you operate like the sons of Sceva with a, you have a profession without the power. They have the formula without the faith. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Right.
Somebody shout
enough.
I'm betrayed into the hands of sinners. Everything, basically, I'm done. Basically, everything that Jesus told them, just like he said it was, is coming to pass. And after they cut the ear off and they arrested Jesus, everybody took off but Peter and John. Y'all remember the story? John went all the way in. Peter went out to the window down there sitting by the fire. Why? Now Peter's operating in the flesh. He's operating in the flesh because now he's into an environment of a situation where he's not prepared for.
That's right.
Why did Peter get nervous and start cursing and say he don't even know Jesus? Because he had not prayed in the garden when Jesus told him to. He was not prepared even for a little girl. So when the girl says, you are one of his disciples, and he starts bringing down curses upon himself, so he would not appear to be a Galilean. He was trying to separate himself from Jesus. Why? Because he didn't have the power to stand with him. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
If you don't have the power to stand with God, the devil will expose you.
Yeah.
And you'll realize, I should have been praying last night instead of watching TV.
Yes.
I should have been praying and reading my Bible instead of watching those TV shows. I don't even know what comes on TV anymore, so if I start quoting your TV show, the only show I know about is Scandal. I've never watched it, but I've heard about it. I don't know what comes on regular TV. I don't watch regular TV. Amen. There's nothing really worth watching. Honestly, my wife and I, most of our time, 90% of our time, we'll watch either Western, some old Western, amen, a cooking show, or backyard makeover. Because the rest of the stuff is just pure junk. It's not going to lead you to the kingdom of God.
Right.
Has nothing godly about it. There's no ethics. I'm not going to start preaching again. But we got to get to a point where it's enough, because Judas is coming. He's coming to your family and he's coming to mine. He's coming to your nieces, your nephews, to your mayor, your governors, even your president.
Yeah.
Amen. People were saying that the other day because they got to fussing and arguing about President Obama. And I said, y'all need to understand, why are you wasting time with this?
Yeah.
He's already there. His birth certificate to me right now is irrelevant.
That's right.
He's there. What we need to do now is focus on the here and the now and what we're going to do next year and the year after that. 2016 is going to come. Why are you living in 2008? You can't repeat that. That's a done deal. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And the devil had people all mixed up. The other day I was listening to Bishop Blake preaching. He was preaching so hard, and he was preaching about homosexuality. He was preaching about abortion. He was preaching about all this stuff. I said, praise God, the church is finally waking up. Amen. But how are you going to preach against something that you voted for people to participate in? Are you hearing what I'm saying? So if you really want to affect change, stop supporting people that don't support you. If they don't support God, don't support them. I don't care if they're Republican, Democrat, Independent, or whatever.
That's right.
Amen. The bottom line is the Word of God. I don't care who, what color they are, whether they male or female, Jew, Gentile, Protestant, or Greek. Amen.
Amen.
Come on up in here. Do they serve God? God's Word is what's going to bring us to all of this. Not another president. Amen. Most of y'all don't live through 8, 10, 12, 15 presidents. Amen. Probably going to live through another 3 or 4 to 5, 10. They come and they go. They come with these ideas about what they're going to do. And guess what? They just like the disciples. They think it's going to be a certain way, and then they get in there and get that power. They get that pen and that phone. And they find out there's other influences that help me make my decisions. I'm not just Mr. President. Amen.
Amen.
Today I'm going to be going out to El Monte. We're having a national day of prayer. It started at 8 o'clock this morning. We're going to be praying at 8 o'clock tonight. Guess what? We're going to be praying for the president. Do I like him? No. But the Bible tells us to pray for our governors and our people that's in charge of us.
Yes.
And I'm praying for God to save him.
Yes.
Sanctify him and fill him with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
I'm praying for God to pray, save the senators, every congressman, every judge. Come on up in here. Supreme Court or otherwise. Save them. Pastor Nolan, you don't like my president. No. Amen. If you read the Bible, you wouldn't like it either. But the bottom line is this. He can change just like you can.
That's right.
God's not a respecter of persons. I've given you all what God gave me to say. Enough. Enough. Stop letting the devil steal your joy when things don't work out like you thought it should. My question I need you to understand is, why do you think the way you thought it should work should work?
Yeah.
Amen. Just because you thunk it don't mean it's right. Amen. Sometimes things don't go your way. You still got to go on.
Yes.
I could have easily just said, you know what? Mending this funeral is the way I wanted it done, so I'm leaving. No, I got up there. I only had 3 minutes to preach. Got up there and preached for my 3 minutes. Gave them the Word of God. Let me tell you something. A lot of people got blessed by those 3 minutes. The devil didn't want that to happen.
Come on.
And I sit there and watch that. But guess what? While I'm up in the middle of the night, I'm praying. Why? Because I know the enemy's coming.
Uh-huh.
Trust me, saints, the enemy's coming your way. The enemy's coming your way. When I was a young minister, the church was this empty, I used to get behind it. Well, back in those days, we had those big pulpits that wouldn't you can see behind them.
Yeah.
Right? I'll be back there crying.
Wow.
Like, because there was nobody in the church.
Wow.
Seriously, I am so serious. And I'll get up there, wipe my eyes, and open up the Bible and preach with nobody in there.
Wow.
It used to bug me to no end. Eight, 9 pages of notes, and I go through it, and be like, and you know what? I was wasting my time. Because the devil had already won, but I was sitting there crying. I shouldn't even got up. I just should have went into prayer because I wasn't prayed up enough.
Uh-huh.
I'm closing. I'm getting ready to let y'all go home so y'all can see the Spurs. But understand this. Now that I'm a little bit older,
come on.
If it's 1,000, 200, or just me,
come on.
Long as I've got the Word of God, I'm going to stand and say what God says, and I'm going forward in the name of Jesus. I've had enough of letting life situations dictate to me how I'm going to respond.
That's right.
You don't get to determine my joy, my happiness, or my peace.
Amen.
You don't have that power.
Amen.
Huh? You, the devil, and anybody that works for him don't have the day because this is the day that the Lord has made. Amen. I'm always going to have a good day.
Yeah.
Amen. And before the sun goes down on any given day, I'm going to leave that day with a smile on my face. Because God is in charge. God is in charge. May not come when I want him, but he's right on time. That's all I have. I have a few more things, but I'm going to leave that with you all. Pray for me. I have to go to, like I said, Almighty for this national day. It's supposed to be a global day of prayer. Then we're going to go to Chino Prison tonight to pray and preach there. And then we'll be leaving for tomorrow to go to Chicago. We'll be there until Thursday. So pray for us. Pray for Sister Nolan. Sister Nolan will be covering you all on Wednesday night. I've already given her the direction for Wednesday night Bible study. But before I sit down, I thank God for Brother Scott. He sent me on Facebook. He says, what did he say? He says, you piqued my interest. I'm going to come see you. And I'm thinking he was in Victorville somewhere. That's a long drive. Victorville is a long drive to me.
Yeah.
Amen. And he said, no, no, pass that. I said, Barstow, go past that. What's the name of that city you're from?
Daggett.
Daggett. He's from Daggett, California. I don't know if any of y'all know where that is. But on your way to Vegas next time to go to the buffet. That's way out there. Amen. I just thank God for that because God knows how to encourage you.
Yes. Yes.
God knows how to encourage you. Just stay prayed up. How's he going to show up and show out?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. If you're not saved today, you've got to be able to tell the devil enough. Some of y'all have some messed up finances, sickness in your body, chaos going on in your house, don't have any peace, no joy. You may even want to stand for someone else. Stand and pray and believe. I believe God. When Jesus was in that garden praying for the cup to depart from him, he wasn't praying for himself.
Yeah.
That was his whole purpose of coming here. He came here to die. This cup was basically, he's praying, let not my dying be in vain.
Yeah.
Huh? My blood is too precious to be wasted on that cross. Let somebody get washed in this blood. Let this change something. Live to be a life changer. They had Maya Angelou's funeral on yesterday. It was so many, what was that? It was a good service. Why? She was a good woman. Amen. I asked my wife, who did the funeral? They said her pastor. So thank God they didn't try to put somebody famous up there. You know, these famous people try to steal the show when famous people die because they know there's a whole lot of people watching. But thank God for this woman wrote some things that you never would imagine. And I've read a lot of our stuff. You know what? A lot of stuff come from plantation days and slavery days. When y'all family and my family and all of our families had to struggle every single day. Amen. You're not going to get those deep poems like that from this generation.
Amen.
Amen. I was listening to my daughter rap stuff. I said, well, she got some original stuff. West Coast, what you call yourself? Long Beach, whatever. Was it West Coast? Yeah. And I was listening because most of these rappers, all they did was they just remixed somebody else's lyrics, put a beat on it, and they call it my project. That ain't your project. That's not your music. You just taking music, and I have people that I work with at nighttime, they listen to music I used to listen to back in the 70s. I said, y'all don't have any music in your age, in your time? What are you talking about? This was good. But seriously, I walk around in this big old giant place, and all I hear is records from the 70s, and these people are younger than you all. Because there's no production. Why would I seek God? So he can open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing they don't have room enough to receive. There's nothing new. They just want to absorb something old and they manipulated it and that's new. No, it's not. Same thing people do with the Word of God. They're not studying God, seeking God for revelation.
Come on.
They go on the internet and they read somebody's book. I'm so sick of these people that Pastor Nolan, doc, give him a book, doc. I was at a prayer breakfast 2 weeks ago. All the pastors down there, and some guy, I don't know who he was, came all the way to our table. Hey, doc, I want you to have my personal book. Doc, I want you to read it. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Amen. That book will still be brand new next year. Amen. I don't even know the whole Bible yet. What do I need your book for?
Come on.
I said, oh, you should read my stuff. That's fine. You read for me. Read for me. I'll give it to you next time I see you. Tell me all about it. Enough. Amen. Listen, I'm personally at my age now, and I'm not that old, I'm not that young. But I'm tired of entertainment. I'm tired of what we call church in America. And I'm tired of what we call a sold-out, dedicated life, because we're nowhere close. We don't really understand what's at stake here. Amen. We don't understand what's at stake. We don't understand the urgency of the time. While we're divided over black, white, saved, sanctified, this or that. I'm serious. Even after I preach the service and I fellowship with the family, I'm on my way home to hurry up and get on to my wife, and there's some guy in the parking lot from an apostolic church, and he wants to sit there and have a theological discourse with me in the parking lot. Well, what are you baptized in? What are you doing? What do you believe in? I said, I believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I believe in Elohim. Amen. Well, who was Jesus talking to? I said, well, from what I read, he was talking to himself. Father, Son, Holy Ghost, and Holy Spirit. One, he had to be talking to himself. There's only one throne in heaven. Oh. And he just kept on going. I said, well, he just asked him, how did those people in the Bible know to write the Bible if they wasn't there? I said, well, the Bible says all scripture is inspired by God. That means God gave them the inspiration to write it.
Yeah.
Amen. Pastor, why are you bringing this up? I just preached a service. The anointing came in. I'm on my way home, and there's a devil in the parking lot wants to argue.
Yes.
In season and out of season.
Yes.
You got to be ready.
Yes.
Amen. You got to get to a point where you have to pray more. Pastor Nolan, I pray, no, we don't. No. Because it would be evident.
Uh-huh.
If there was more prayer going on before you got here, it would be evident. It would be evident. I was sitting in my chair today, and I was listening to the praise and worship. And I said, he wasn't really doing anything. And all of a sudden, I felt for about a good 45 seconds, I felt the presence of God. I said, yeah, that's it. Then stopped again. What happened is because somebody decided to get up and sing without praying first. You didn't pray yesterday. You didn't pray last week. You just felt like because I know C sharp and the words to the song, I can get up there and sing it. It don't work like that. Because it just don't. If I was a crying man, I'd probably be up here weeping right about now. Because to me, it's just sad that people just go through life like it's no big deal. Everything you do is a big deal. Everything you don't do is a big deal. You are a big deal. I'm a big deal. We're a big deal.
Yes.
What are you talking about? Well, if it was not such a big deal, he would have never went there. It was a big deal for him to go there, to go through all that, so that we can be here to help somebody else along the way. Martin Luther King said, I don't tell people about my many awards or my Nobel Peace. He says, tell him I was a drum major. If I can help somebody along the way,
yes,
through a word or song,
yes,
then I know my living wasn't in vain.
Yes, yes.
This is what Jesus was telling me. He's facing this cross with people that's not realizing, this is it. It's my turn. What am I going to do with it? Come on, say, neighbors, now it's your turn. What are you going to do with it? You can't depend on the preacher all the time. You better be able to do it for yourself. The preacher can't come to your house, but you can go.